I think we'd be really interested to know, when you were doing the research for your book, what were the things that people were saying they were looking out for when buying artwork?
Well, I think almost I'd like to turn that question on its head a bit, because I think for me it's slightly more sort of what not to overlook in many ways. I think that's partly sort of fear, and that's also partly through sort of not quite understanding some mediums. I mean, prints I think are a completely amazing way of, you know, really affordable and accessible entry level way of buying art. But some people are really put off. They sort of think original prints are the same as reproduction prints. And original prints, you know, are handmade by the artist. And then because there are many of them, it's a very democratic way for artists to produce work, and just means many more people can invest in them.
There are quite a few key things to look out for, I think, when you are purchasing prints. As you said, editioning is one of them, and the section in your book says them kind of bullet-pointed very coherently, and it's having the correct editions and knowing what that means as well. They look like little fractions at the bottom or sometimes on the back of the piece, but if it's a limited edition of 25, you need to know things like the first five will actually be more valuable if you're buying for investment purposes, as well as the end ones, but the ones in the middle not so much. And so kind of things like that that are good to know if you are considering buying a print.
And artist proof, it's got a
AP, and always look for a signature, because even if they are prints, they're still an original piece of artwork and they should all be signed by the artist. And you can always ask your gallery as well, which is quite a nice touch, if they can actually personalise that piece, so the artist could put a little message to you on the back, and your gallery can arrange that for you if you wanted. That was something that you
makes it extra special.
Yeah.
And I think in a similar way, I feel that about sculpture as well, that sometimes sculpture can be something that people are frightened of, because, you know, it is sort of 3D and you do live with it.
We have this conversation before, and we have it regularly with our clients. What is art? Is it painting? Well, it is painting, but it's also photography, print, sculpture, obviously video art, digital work. There's a huge, wide breadth of work that you could be buying.
And then I guess the thing that you guys specialise in, which is work by emerging artists, obviously it's easy to go for artists who are established, whose name you know, but it's really a real adventure to invest in. It's an ethical investment in someone at an early stage of their career. You don't know where it's going to go. Their prices are generally lower, but they could skyrocket.
Absolutely.
And you know, they're really energetic and vital and enthusiastic.
I mean, we choose artists who we see as having the potential to have careers as artists, but they're not going to just be an artist for a year and go and do something else. But they're artists who are going to stick at what they're doing, develop their practice.
Committed.
Yeah, absolutely, and have a career which will develop.
I guess that's the advantage of buying, you know, through a gallery you trust, and you know that they would have selected emerging artists who they really believe are going to be
there for nurture.
I think galleries and nurturing artists is really important.
Yeah.
Helping their career, making sure they're taking the right steps.
Yeah.
So I think emerging artists, definitely if they're being supported by a gallery,